Coffee. G'day YouTube, Dr. Sue here. Today I'm going to attempt to install Plex valves from FFRC in Australia, and I have no idea what I'm doing, but they have a website and they sort of describe it on the website. So alright, what I think I need is a crowbar, a measuring jug, some 10 weight fork oil, toolbox full of spanners, a tray with some newspaper in it, a bowl, some more tools, and some more tools. So far what I've done is I've put down a drop sheet, I've chucked my bike up on the jack, and I've loosened the top nuts, the fork caps. What I did actually first was I marked the, because I don't have a torque wrench, so I marked the top of the fork clamp so I know where they go when I put them back in. But apparently if you loosen these first when they're still in the triple trees, it's easier to undo the nut. So yeah, that's kind of where I'm at so far. Let's get into it. Alright, so we've got to loosen the speedo retainer thingy here, so we'll get rid of that. I'll take that off. Set that aside. So we loosen the pinch bolts. Oh shit, they're on there tight. Like so. And we'll loosen the axle. Remove the axle. Do not lose that. Cool. Front wheel off. All right. So, remove the brake caliper. Those bolts are on there really tight. Okie dokie. Might have to put some grease on those, I think. Gloves come in handy. See, I put them on before I put them on, if you know what I mean. Oh, coffee. Ah. So, good trick. Just want to keep this out of the way. Stretchy strap. Alright. So, speedo drives off, brake calipers off, wheels off. Now we slide the forks out. Alright. Loosening the nuts. loosen the bolts. All right, loosen the other side. Righty tighty, lefty loosey. Now we should be able to remove the forks. One. Two. Okie dokie. Move the fork caps. Drop the spanner. Remove the fork caps. Ka-ching. Remove preload spacer. Remove washer. Remove spring. I'll just let that drain for about 10 minutes and do the other one. Letting them drain for about 15 minutes. For about 5-10 minutes. So yeah, there's our springs and shit. I've got the sides marked out. I've got what way the springs go back in. Everything laid out. I find it makes it easier when you're putting shit back together to have everything laid out. And then yeah, you don't have to go back to the computer with greasy hands to double check everything. It looks crazy, man. Like, looks like a dude with his front teeth knocked out. Oh, on a side note, I don't know if you can see my new rocks risers, 2-inch rise. Now I can stand up on the bike without stooping over, because I'm about 5'10", and I found that off-road I was struggling a bit to stand up. The position on the bike was a bit but sort of hunched over and not very comfortable. It was affecting my ability to control the bike off-road, so I went on to online and was looking at options for risers, and these seem to be the ones to go for. And yeah, they seem to work pretty good. They're kind of cool because they fit onto your original risers, but you can move them back and forwards to adjust them, which is kind of cool. Yeah, lots of adjustment. I put on this piece here just to stabilize the front screen, because it was flapping around a bit, so I thought I'd chuck a piece on. And it's actually quite cool because I can mount things to it, you know, GPS and or whatever, bibs and bobs, you know. It's all solid and pretty cool. So yeah, cool. So forks are drained. Now we got our plexi valves. That's what they look like. We drop these in the forks with the solid spacer facing up. So yeah, down inside the fork there. Oh, look at that! Isn't that interesting? Solid spacer facing up, and it goes. May as well put the other one in as well while I'm here. All the way compressed, solid spacer facing up. Cool bananas. Now we've got to put, they say approximately 575 mils of oil in the fork. The Plex valves will work with 5 weight, 10 weight, 15 weight, but they recommend that you use 10 weight oil. The bike had 5 weight in it, but I'm going to change it up to 10 weight because I want a bit more compression damping. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so I got the first one done. During the process, it worked pretty good. During the process, my fucking GoPro battery ran out. So I'm going to have to explain all this shit again, fucking helicopters and shit. So that's okay. So where I'm at now is I've put 575 mils of oil into the shock. First I put the Plex valve in, then I put in 575 mils of oil. And now, what I'm, oh, at the start of the video I said I needed a crowbar. The reason for that is I need to be able to keep the shock upright. Obviously I don't have a vice out here, so, and instead of walking all the way down to the shed and then walking all the way back up again, I thought, what can I use to hold the fork up? And crowbar seems to work pretty good, so that's where I'm at. But what we're going to do now is we're going to bleed the fork just to make sure we have oil in all the little crevices and cracks and all the way into the shock. You can actually feel the Plex valves working already, which is a good sign. I've actually, before I started filming this, I was wanking it up and down like this already for a little while, so it doesn't have to be done too much more. That should do it. So all right, now we have to set the air gap, which is the amount of air above the oil in the shock. So with the shock in the compressed position, and making sure we have enough oil in the top of the shock, that's the rest of the 575 mils. Now, how do we set the air gap to the oil? Well, I don't have a tool to do this, so what I did was I made a tool to do this. And as I'm a pro cycle junkie, I had a syringe lying around. And what I've done is I've put a piece of plastic tube into the syringe, and I've got a cable tie here, and I measured from the bottom of the piece of plastic tube up to the top of the cable tie is exactly 110 mil. So now what we do is we rest that on the top of the fork like this, and we suck out the oil. Like so. Can you even fucking see that? And we keep going until we, until all we're sucking is air. A bigger syringe may have been the go, but that's the only syringe I had lying around. Find these things come in handy. All sorts of applications. Maybe I put too much oil in here. Oh well, fuck it. Too much is better than not enough. Oh, there we go. So yeah, just make sure we're at exactly 110 mils. Cool. So now the gap between the oil and the top of the fork should be exactly 110 mils. Okie dokie. So now we're at the stage where we can reassemble the fork. So what we got to do is take our spring. As I said earlier, I laid it out so I knew which way to put the spring back in. Put the spring back in the fork, and then we're going to turn that anti-clockwise so that the we know the Plex valve is seated properly. Extend up the fork leg, and now we take our washer, put that in. Take our spacer, put that in, and now chuck the cap back on. And now I've got oil all over my hands and it's going to be slippery. Oh well, who cares? Oh, you fucking bastard. All right. Where's my spanner? Oh, there it is. Tighten up the cap as much as you can. Once I put the forks back in the bike. Yep, that's good. Once I put the forks back in the bike, I'll give it a final tighten. Once they're locked in, and we should be good to go. So yeah, I've got my forks lined up with the top of the fork cap. Where it meets the fork is the line I use to gauge how far up the fork is. So it's lined up with my little mark on there. Yep, just double check. Clearance needs to go up just a smidge. Just a smidge more. Just give it a little tap like that. Yep, good. Good. Okay, good. So we'll just give these a little. Tighten them here. just making sure that the that they're aligned correctly. That just slipped back down again, you motherfucker. Okay, just give it a quick preliminary thingy-majiggy to hold it in place. Hey, teeth back, awesome. Good. Sweet. Now we tighten up the bolts, chuck the wheel back on. Tightening up the bolts. Yeah, I'm not too sure what these are supposed to be torqued at, but tight. Don't want my forks coming out. The other side. Cool. Right. Now we tighten these ones up. Not as tight as last time because I won't be able to get them undone again if I have to rebuild something or something, I don't know. Are you properly torqued? No, they're not talking. Boom. Wheel back on now. Actually, before we put the wheel back on, I think we should reassemble the brake caliper back on the fork leg. That might be a good idea. Now, if you're not a mechanic like me, a good idea is to write everything down and then tick it off as you go. And I find you don't tend to, you know, get everything finished and go, oh shit, I forgot to put a washer in, oh no, I've got to re-bloody do everything and pull it all back apart again and shit. So yeah, it's a good idea to tick things off. So bleed the forks, I've done that. Blah blah blah, air gap, I've done that. See, the battery running out on my GoPro's kind of throwing me out a wee bit. Remove excess oil, I did that. Insert washer, blah 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 blah. Compress spring and fit fork cap, blah 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 blah. Install forks back on bike. I did give them a bit of a clean first, and I've tightened up the top caps, making sure that they're nice and tight. Okay, replace wheel, brake assembly, and speedo line. All right, so we'll do that. Those things are real handy to have. Okie dokie. Now, where's my screwdriver at? Here it is. So, how did that go? Like this. Yeah, like that. So we'll chuck that back in there like that. Q. Bolts. Now, do I want to put grease on those? Or Loctite? Nah, fuck it. You know what? I'm not going to put nothing on those. We're just fucking... Now, how the fuck did that go? Like that. Did it go like that? Where did that go? Oh, like that. Doo! Chuck our nuts back in the hole. Now, these were done up really tight. suppose it's probably a good idea. You don't want your brake caliper coming off. Let's get some. I keep putting bloody grubby marks all over my nice clean bike. It's a dirt bike. Cool. Brake caliper is on. Alright. Now, where's my lithium grease? There it is. Now there's a little spacer here. Don't put the wheel back on without frickin' forgetting to put that back in. Everything should be greased. Nice and greasy. Okie dokie. Now, did that go on the outside or the inside? That went on the inside. That went on the inside. Does that go under or over? Under or over? Oh yeah, it goes like this. Oh, there goes my fucking spacer. Okay. Axle. Jesus, that was the hardest bit. Getting the fucking wheel back on. Holy. Jesus. Okie dokie. So, all the bolts are tight. Wheels back on. That turned out to be the hardest part of the whole fucking thing. What I haven't done is tightened up these pinch bolts. Because when I looked online to raise the front forks. Shut up! Making a video. Piss off! Good boy. Sorry about that. When I raised the suspension back up to up through, because it was dropped up, it was up here. And I put the forks back to proper height, redid the back to the proper height and everything. And they said, when you do that, you should loosen the pinch bolts on the front. And then before you tighten them back up again, just to stop it, the axle from binding, leave them loose and give it a couple of pumps up and down on the front. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'll just raise that up, take the safety off, make sure there's nothing underneath the bike that'll tip it over and fuck it up. Okay, let the bike down, 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 down. Right. That out the way. Give them a pump. Oh, that feels good. Just give it a bit of a pump there. Cool. Some reason they say tighten the top ones first. I'm going to tighten them all at the same time. And now the one thing you do not want to do is over tighten these, because apparently they can snap and you don't want them to snap. I find if these look about the same, then you've got it pretty much bang on. So good. Well, yeah, that's how you install Plex valves into the front forks on a DR650. Yeah, that was actually really easy. And I'll take it for a ride in a minute, and I'll film that too and chuck it on the end of the video just to give you a little idea of how good it is. But from what I can feel, the front end's not, seems to not be diving as much. That feels pretty bloody good if you ask me. All right, let's take it for a ride. All right, move it, cat. So, first impressions. There's no front brake dive. That feels awesome. Speed bump. That was doing 80 k's. That was hardly anything. Jesus, that feels fucking amazing. That feels bloody incredible. I think the word would be plush. Plush is the word? Yeah, plush. It's a huge improvement. Huge improvement. Wow, man, that's incredibly good. That's worth the money. Okay. So, in conclusion, if you don't have Plex valves in the front of your DR650, go on the FFRC website and buy some. And then if you don't know how to put them in, watch my video. Well, you've already watched my video. And put them in. Because that is fucking awesome. It completely transformed the feel of the bike. I mean, it's I actually have front suspension now, so yeah, really, really happy. If you're wondering why I didn't go the Cogent DDC or Gold Valve emulator route, I did think about getting those. Then I watched Adventure Oz's video on Plex valves and went, yeah, that, yeah, actually that's what sold me on them. You know, if DR's doing a 50-foot jump with stock springs, stock oil, and all they did was put Plex valves in it, you know, it's pretty good. And I mean, that's those guys know what they're talking about. They're very trustworthy. I've subscribed to their channel, and if you haven't, you should. Also, Adventure Oz has a, I think his name's Bruce, he's got another channel called Cross Training and Enduro Skills. You should check that one out too, because it's pretty good. Yeah, well, next what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy a Cogent Mojave shock from Pro Cycle. That's coming up shortly. Some new pegs, maybe some peg lowers. I think I'm going to go with the Fastway Evo Air pegs, in orange, obviously. I was going to get the Adventure pegs, the Fastway Adventure pegs, but I think they might be a wee bit too wide. I like to lean the bike over in turns on the road and shit, so I don't want to be scraping pegs on the shit. What else? Yeah, I'm getting a couple more blingy parts. I'm replacing the plasticky bit on the chain guard one with a JNS chain guard. Maybe a Warp 9 brake pedal. What else? Oh, and a steel braided front brake line. And a new front rotor, because the guy told me that it's below the legal limit, so I have to replace that. I'm going to get a Warp 9 one. Yeah, but other than that, fuck, she's a beast now, man. If you don't have a DR650, buy one. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. And yeah, I'll see you later. But yeah, Plex valves seems to work pretty good. I'll catch you later. Cheers, guys.